Hi there, welcome to the fifth lesson of our Dialogflow series. In this lesson, we'll be learning what entities are in Dialogflow and what you can do with them in Landbot. One of the powerful features that Dialogflow offers is the ability to extract information out of the user's input and store it in a variable that we can later use. Those variables where we store those inputs are called entities. In this lesson, we're going to use the example of a restaurant reservation to extract such information. So when the user asks to make a reservation, it will gather when and for how many people they want a reservation. So, for example, if the user types, "I want a table for two for Friday 14th, we will store two as the number of people and Friday 14th as the reservation date. This data that will be captured in Dialogflow as entities will be stored in Landbot variables like @people and @reservationDate, for example, to later use in our CRM or booking system. Instead of storing the whole sentence of "I want a table for two for Friday 14th, which might not be very useful for our systems. So let's do it. We will start in Dialogflow, creating an intent for all those users that want to make a reservation. We will call it reservation trailer. Based on the spreadsheets from previous lessons, I've added common sentences to build a set of possible ways a user might tell us that is interested in making a reservation. As you can see, some of them have all the information that we need, this being people and daytime of the reservation. But some others might only have one or none, which will also deal with those types of answers. Now, one by one, we will add those sentences in the intent we just created. Sometimes, when we add a training phrase, Dialogflow will highlight part of the sentence. That part is what Dialogflow considers an entity. Down in the section Actions and Parameters is where we can set different configurations, like the name of the parameter, for example. Something to keep in mind is that there are two types of entities, custom entities and system entities. The main difference is that the system entities are default Dialogflow entities. They are quick and ready to use, like this one. Custom entities, on the other hand, are not ready, and you need to create them from the entities section. These ones are very useful for specific names or keywords that Dialogflow doesn't recognize by default, like, for example, the name of the pizzas. So let's add the rest of the training phrase. As you can see from this training phrase, Dialogflow recognizes two entities, @sysNumber and @sysDateTime. Now, once we've added all the phrases in the section Action and Parameters, we will set the parameters as required to make sure that the user gives us when the reservation is and for how many people. Once we set required, on the right side, we will see a new tab called Define Prompts. Click on it. Now we need to set up each of the prompts that will be triggered if the user's input doesn't have the information we need. So we'll add a sentence that will obligate the user to give us the information we need. And we do the same for the other entity. Great. Finally, let's finish the setup of the intent with a response sentence. Now save it, wait until the training is complete, and let's do some testing to see if the information is captured correctly. I'll type, "I would like a reservation for 3 tomorrow." And as you can see, the information is gathered correctly. Let's now go to Landbot. This bot was built in previous lessons, so make sure to watch them if you haven't. We want Landbot to save in variables the entities from Dialogflow. So inside the block settings, go to the Save the Response section and press on Add Entities. First, we'll add the parameter name. In our case, the first one is daytime. So we add it with the same name, daytime. And now we set the Landbot variable where we want to store the value. We will use @reservationDate. Now let's do the same with the other entity. Great. And that's all. Now, if you tried the bot, you'll be able to use those new variables where we store the entities received from Dialogflow. That was our fifth lesson of our Dialogflow series. In the next and final lesson, we will learn how to redirect users to different flows depending on their response parameters. I'm Nick, and I'll see you in the next one.